Next topic. Before we go to concurrency control, we must understand what are schedules. What are schedules in databases? Schedule is a sequence of instructions that specify the chronological order in which instructions of concurrent executions transactions are executed into the concurrent system. A schedule for a set of transactions must consist of all the instructions of those transactions. It means that when we design a schedule for a set of transactions, there may be n number of transactions happening in concurrently. So a schedule may consist of all those transactions into it, right? It consists of all those transactions that are executing concurrently. A transaction can have 10 statements, maybe another transaction may be having 20 statements into it. When the third transaction may be having 30 statements into it, means when we design a schedule for these three transactions, then all the instructions of all the transactions must be incorporated into the schedule. Second thing is that schedule must preserve the order in which the instructions appear in each individual transaction. Means while designing the schedule, we must inform to the system or CPU that which transaction instructions will going to execute now, and after that which transaction will going to execute, means which instructions from that particular transaction will going to execute. That sequence has to be decided. So that order is called as schedule. Schedule is a sequence of instructions that specify chronological order in which instructions of concurrent transactions are executed. Okay. A transaction that successfully completes its execution will have a commit instruction always at the last statement in the transaction. This is only for successful transaction. And for unsuccessful transaction, the last statement would be rollback. For unsuccessful transaction, the last statement would be rollback. By default, transaction assumed to execute commit instruction as its last step. If it is successful. Let us understand in detail with the example, what do you mean by schedule? Now consider there are two transactions happening into the system, like first transaction P1 transfers rupees 50 from A to B, whereas second transaction is transferring 10% of the balance of account A to account B. So for that, I want to design a schedule. This particular example is an example of serial schedule, because all the instructions of T1 transactions are executed first, and then after completing T1 transaction, we are starting T2 transactions. So all the instructions of T2 transactions are appearing after T1 completes. So what we are doing in transaction T1, we want to transfer 50 rupees from account A to account B, or $50 from account A to account B. Then how are we going to write the instruction for that particular transaction? We must first read account A, then subtract 50 rupees from it, and at last you have to write A. It means you have to perform write A operation to update the balance of account A. Then we go to account B. There we read account B. Then we add 50 rupees into account B. And at last we close the transaction by writing the statement write B. It means we update the balance of account B. Now let's see what are the instructions of transaction T2. Here we wanted to transfer 10% of the amount of account A's balance to account B. So for that, again we'll go to account A, and the first instruction that we do here is read A. Next is find 10% of it. So we use the variable temp equal to A into 0.1 or 0.10, one and the same thing, right? So we calculate 10%. This is the formula for that. Then we subtract that amount from account A. So it is A equal to A minus 10. And then at last we want to update the account A. So for that we have statement write A. Whenever you perform write A, you are updating account A. After that, we'll go to account B. They will add temp, that is 10% of account A. And the formula is B equal to B plus temp. This will calculate total amount and then store it into B variable. And then at last, we want to update that value into account B. So for that, we have write B is the instruction for it. This schedule S1, I'm giving the name to this particular schedule S1, say, or schedule 1, is called serial schedule because all the instructions of one transactions are appearing before executing the second transaction. So T2 transaction will going to start only after T1 gets completed. So this is one possibility of a serial schedule for two transactions, T1 and T2. Now what would be the another possibility? All the instructions of T2 transaction must be executed first and then you start T1 transaction. That is second possibility. So the second schedule is having that example where we have another serial schedule. This is also a serial schedule where all the instructions of T2 transaction are executed first and it is followed by T1 transaction. It means that while designing the schedule, you can decide which transaction to execute first and which transaction to execute later on. Correct.